This video will introduce you to the Vectorizer editor. It will be a general overview of the four editing panels. To get to the editor, just choose a preset and then toggle to the editor, here. There are four panels in the Vectorizer editor: Generation, Drawing Setup, Drawing Apply, and Composite. I will briefly go through some of these settings in each of these panels. There are other videos that go into greater detail. Before we try a few edit settings, I want to show you a new feature in Studio Artist 5.5, which are quick edits for the Vectorizer. You can find these in the Edit menu. I am going to use it to initialize the preset so we can start with something very simple. There are a lot of very useful quick edits you can use here without having to go into the editor. I strongly encourage you to try these out for yourself. The generation panel sets the source that the Vectorizer uses to process. Most Vectorizer presets are set to the source image. This panel also has various filtering operations. Two important filters in this panel are the main technique and the generator. The main technique is the basic shape of the output. I will just quickly show you some examples of each, as well as some different generators. The image technique uses the source image for its shape. Since we are already in this mode, and the image in the canvas is already using this technique, I will show you some generators that will affect the canvas image shape. There are endless variations that you can achieve with these settings alone. This RGA effect setting will change the shape of the regions in the image. Here is an example. Before I continue to the next technique, I am just going to reinitialize the image with the Quick Edits menu. Next is the Shape technique. This technique generates various shapes. I will just go through a few settings to demonstrate. Again, there are endless variations in this panel. Now I will show you a few edits using the outline technique. You can adjust the threshold with this slider. This is an example of the flat output technique. And this is an example of the image triangle technique. Again, this is just a small sample of the potential variety with this technique. Next, we will explore the drawing setup panel. The drawing setup handles backgrounds, changes the shapes of the vector regions, as well as manages color. Here are a few settings to demonstrate. The region effect pull down menu lets you pick the shape of the regions, and there are a lot of choices as you can see. Here you can randomize the regions. The main color options are located here. There are also randomization options that affect the color. The drawing apply panel has outline types, as well as vector shadowing and fill options. Many of these are unique to Studio Artist. Let me show you a few things. I'm going to pick a new preset to get started. Here you can change what the vector regions are filled with. For this dual fill option, this is the pull-down menu to choose what shape you want your fill to be. Next, I'm going to show you a few cast shadow effects unique to Studio Artist. This one is a soft extrusion with randomized diffusion. There are several settings for these shadow effects such as blend, offset, diffuse amount and random amounts. This is where you can choose the shadow angle. This is another fun shadow effect. This option uses the rim outline from the extrusion shadow effect. This pull-down menu gives you color options for your shadow effects. I want to touch on another cool option in this panel. the bars and jitter bars. In the vector fill options, let me show you a few examples. You can change the spacing with this slider. With the bar angle mod, you can change how the bars appear in the regions. The bar space mod will affect the space between the bars. Here is a different style of bars called jitter bars. I encourage you to play around with all these settings in the Draw Apply panel. Next, we will look at the last panel. This last panel is for compositing. You can also choose the color space and how many times you want to repeat your effect, as well as the mix. This panel also has a very cool feature, which is the Smart Edge Sketch, where you can add artistic sketch outlines. Let's try a few. There are three different styles to choose from. You can choose the width of the pen stroke here. And you can choose the color here. Let's try these other sketch choices. You can use this threshold slider to change the amount of the sketch effect. And you can use this one for the mix. This Smart Edge Effect pull-down menu gives you a lot of sketch shape choices. There are some that are pretty wild, and some that are more subtle. Let's try a few. I really encourage you to play around with the editing panels in the Vectorizer, and to save your presets to your favorites folder when you get something you like. Have fun exploring!